Wow. Another new fine day today. Good evening, everybody. First, let me ask for God's guidance for this evening. And Happy New Year to those who are coming in for the first time today, too. We met last night, and I promised to be on board at 9 o'clock exactly, which is 9 p.m. by Italian time. Wow, my big brother Budi, that's nice of you. You are with us tonight, right? We're just trying to talk about one illiterate that claimed to be in the U.S., but he's living on top of the tree in the U.S. This evening we have more information about Comrade Eranomingho. For those of them who were clapping hands for him the other day, that we don't know what we are saying. We know what we are saying. No one could stay in Italy here for many years, and one the riffraff will come from nowhere and start siphoning the other inning of the little girls and men in this Italy here today. Let us just go straight to the point, because in my last topic I discussed about how this man has come to be lying to people in this place here, trying to get money from them. Fellow Nigerians, I'm not a man that normally comes to social media for all this kind of thing, but I think I said enough is enough. He has done a lot. If he has never one day spoke about our comrade governor Obaseki, I would not be interested about him. And even if he insulted any politician in Nigeria, I wouldn't be interested. But I was not comfortable with him insulting a man that was voted into power just up to just three months. No magic. Not even Obama could even achieve anything in a year in the U.S. Regard to what he's doing right now in Bologna, we all are aware, few of Nigerians are not aware, but majority of people who live in Emilia Romagna are aware that the so-called blessing that I spoke about yesterday, the truth is becoming to be emerging out of what we said. Some days ago, you poll those who are conversant with media, we found out that the elder sister who was living in Bologna before went to my gentle friend in Germany. Because Eranomingho called, what's his name again? I always forget this man's name in Germany. Telling him that to arrest the father of Blessing, that they are constricting her to do prostitution. Okay. But his sister's statement yesterday, oh no, 3 days ago, confirmed to us that she was planning to go back to Africa for a visit with her kids. And he sent a car to Nigeria and told the father that this car I will leave it for you, so you have to claim the car in Lagos. When I use it for 2 or 3 weeks, I will leave the car for you. The father was very happy, but she was surprised that it was not a thing of her father. When the father said anything, he normally does it right. So unfortunately, she was still asking, have you started doing the process of the car? Because the car, tomorrow you enter the car. So the father was playing him left to right. So well, if that car has Dumorich, he will not come back to Nigeria again. He will leave everything for you. I'm going to give you the car, you know. Say one day the father collapsed and crawled down on statement and telling local, I remitted 1.5 million to one Eranomingho's account instructed by your sister. As we are told that that money was also sent by Blessing from Bologna to Nigeria in his father's account. Probably the father is a custodian. Maybe we all know that. When you have kids in overseas, either you entrust your account or your finance with your mother, or you entrust it with your father, or you entrust it with your best friend, or your sister you trust most, or your brother you trust most. Then they begin to understand, why is this thing going on? You say, you pick a phone and call Blessing. So look, this man is promising to give him documents. Nigerians, just listen very carefully. That a man of caliber, Timber, as claimed by Eranomingho, he's not living with a girl that has no document, a refugee who has a refugee status and not yet confirmed. Living with her in Bologna, staying with her. We were even told that this lady, this young girl, is just 23 of age, because the sister came to Italy 9 years ago, 10 years ago. She left Italy here some 8 years ago to a year or 2 years ago to Germany. She's not living in Germany now. Why am I coming to this issue again now? So that people will hear details of everything that I'm saying today. That I'm not just saying it for saying sake or because I'm against him or I'm jealous like one fool today. I will use that word because I've never been so succeed on my live video with Nigerians or anybody that is against. You can be against me. It's very logical. Everybody has his own way of expressing his views on media. He said the keto is calling the pot black, you know. He said a lot of stupid things, right? And this is somebody I know very well, but he's ashamed to identify himself in the Facebook. So he kept Goodluck Jonathan with a dreadlock on his head and claimed to be one max cell like that. But I know him very well. He's a frustrated human being that couldn't be able to take care of his family. It is not to make his iniquity that matters a lot, but to take care of his iniquity here that matters a lot. Anyway, let us not take our time and let's go to the words that are very constructive this evening. So, Eranomingho promised to marry this girl. He's not dragging the girl with the family now that they want to marry a girl that is in Aduro. This is freedom fighter. Because from the beginning when I said I look at the fools, I was always in the back of his video. There are always people that cannot be right to anywhere. There are people that are not even reasonable. People that don't even know anything concerning the institution of Italy here. So, this same gentleman instructed the father to pay money. To pay money in Nigeria. The father said he changed, let me know, 2 million again. She requested another $2,500 fine, but they need to send the money in dollars, not in naira. So they went to go and do the exchange in Benin and paid heavy interest on it to remit it to the Eranomingho's account. But with the explanation that Blessing gave, we know that when you know women are when they think they sweet them, they can always defend undefendable issues. We know that when you are telling a woman that this man is a 4-1, that you tell you, look, you don't even know him, that he knows that man for 20 years. But the day will dump her, she will not tell you, but I married him. We all know what is happening in Italy here. The experience which those who stayed here for a very long time. When they are in love, everybody is nonsense. It's only that man they are in love with that is reasonable and intelligent. She claimed that money was not for her, that is, but for Eranomingho, that she's even still owing Eranomingho's hand, Eranomingho's money. I want to ask a question. If PFM money was being donated to PFM account, how come that Blessing was not the person that has the account of the PFM, a girl that is just asking for political refugee in Italy, a girl that have not even spent 2-3 years in Italy, becomes the secretary and the treasurer and the bobo for Eranomingho? We're even told that there are two girls are living with them in that house there, owned by the same girl that is still under the refugee statute, that has not got paper yet. I mean, Nigerians are telling me to keep quiet. And this will continue to happen. People start running away from this place. They go to UK, go to America, go to everywhere. They say Italy is bad, it's bad, it's bad, it's bad. Those places we are running to, people sacrifice their self, their life, everything they have, to make it to what it means, what it is today, that makes every Nigerian or everybody in the world want to mingle with their Americans, want to be in the UK, want to be in Canada, want to be in Japan, want to be in those places we're talking about today now. Why will he allow this man that is frustrated in America? You, a white man, you get married to a white lady, you were frustrated. You took one Igbo woman that almost killed you. You were in TB Joshua confessing, hey, it was true, it's true, it's true, it's true. You confess that the woman was the one. There was a man in your house. You that is using your hand to knock chest now in Italy. Most of your followers don't even know your story very well, okay? So, these two guests, we were even told that you are the one that even remembering them the time to go and also. And we are aware too. Blessing, you are defending him now because of what he's giving to you at this moment now, okay? But remember that 40,000 euros, or $40,000, euros, yes, your sister confirmed it in television, that a white man gave you 40,000 to elevate your poverty in your family. Okay? So every family was aware of it, but this money never went to Nigeria, was not used in any way to help the PFM organization on how to reconstruct or construct or assist those guests who are in shallows in Italy here. But every Nigerians are saying we shouldn't talk to this very stupid man. This man has come to Italy here because he looked at Italy as a dumping ground where they can make money, extract money from girls and those illiterate in this place here. Sorry, I'm not trying to insult you. Illiterate means that those who are not educated. If you don't go to school, you are illiterate, okay? But what I'm saying is that the findings is concluded. We are also aware that you personally called this guy, this man that called himself media president in Germany. You called him personally, insinuating him to arrest the father of a blessing in Nigeria because you want to close them. Say that they are forcing blessing to go to road work, and you don't want her to go to road work. Mabini, it's accepted. You want to give her document, ID card. You said anybody that have ID card in Italy here, they can be able to have residence permit in Italy here. PFM. With ID card or PFM, you get resident in this place. Not even Buhari can give anybody residence in this place here. Not even Berlusconi can give person residence in this place here. If the person has not passed through the due process in Italy here. And most Nigerians don't know what is going on, and they are all making noise up and down. Dadio, right down. God bless you, sir. God bless you, sir. Enough is enough. Those of you who don't want to talk, you can keep quiet. I'm not interested. I don't really want anybody to support me because it doesn't really need much money to deal with this man. We've got all the facts we wanted. If blessing start denying it, that it's not true. If the father want to work with us, he just sent us the receipt where he used to transfer the money to Eranomingho. Even though that money was for the PFM, want to know organization that was organized, that is fighting for human rights in Italy here, how the money was being transferred to Nigeria, how the money was being transferred again to an account of the leader. These are fallacies. We all know that. So the better for you, blessing, you need to leave the coven you are now, because you are in the devil coven. You should know that. If you don't leave it very soon now, you and him will go and dwell in jail. Eranomingho, you cannot use here to be your resident. If you want to marry a woman after 30 years in Europe, at my age now, I will propose it to a 22 years old girl for marriage, for money's sake. But I don't know whether Nigerians are following what I'm saying. Whatever I pronounce here today, if anyone is a lie, let any Nigerians quote me wrong today. These are facts. Most of us know this since here, but not everybody are able to come out on social media and say things that they want to say. Probably some of them, they might be shy, or probably maybe some of them, they don't want to bring themselves out in the media. Okay? But that does not mean that this man is not doing what he's doing. Okay? So, please, fellow Nigerians, I am saying it because I will say I need to don't start again, but I'm not interested about that. It is my nature, and I'm working towards what I'm supposed to do. It's my responsibility to see things as is wrong and put it right. Eranomingho, return the money back to the family. Because all what you are planning, the sister came. She said he traveled 6 hours in a different state, probably maybe the southern part of Germany, to the northern part of Germany. To confirm, he said he's not even using it to say anything, that the sister stopped, it doesn't even work in the road. Okay, that she herself too, she did not deny it. He said she did the same job too. Before she got pregnant, she is fat. Those who were not online will not see this lady. She's fat. He said she's not here to disgrace anybody. But because the matter is becoming going too far in family issues. So, you are saying you are trying to assist her, but you want to marry a 22 years old girl. And that is total bullshit. For a man like you that live in state, officer comrade, you call yourself. I've not even seen where they use that one as a title. That a warder or a calamity man will not go to Nigeria. I will say, look, I'm a sergeant or Yosono Marashello. You don't use those as a title. Your name is your name. You become a warder in America and you are not using that one as a title in Italy. Yeah. Officer comrade, Eranomingho. The other woman called you, they say Eranomingho. I mean, I call you that. I've forgotten what he called you that day. Say Eranomingho, Eranomingho. Yeah. That's what he called you that day. And we've understood that from most of your family members are not even in support of what you are doing over here. I told you that time. I said, look, your days are numbered. You don't believe me, right? We are in the first half period now. Let me finish enjoying myself very well at home first. Then, Bologna is very close here. It's 85 kilometers. I have compiled all the recording on the sister, telephone calls, everything with me. They are with me. We are going to the Questura di Bologna. I make a special donation against you. If this girl wants to support you or want to deny what you've done to her because at the moment, she still believes in you. Maybe she's been brainwashed by your romance or your kiss. I don't know. Then at the end, the police will always find out the truth. This is not Nigeria where they use batting or put needle in your private part to tell you to confess. Here they will analyze the facts. Analyze the fact, the proofs, everything we need, we have it already in our hands. You supposed to be online today by 8 o'clock, but I waited 8 o'clock, you were not before I went and I came back now. If you're online again, if people replied you, because if you replied me, if you write me anything now, as I'm talking now, I will reply you immediately. Because I know what I'm saying is true. If you want me to give you evidence, I'll give you evidence. But the only evidence I cannot give you evidence is written on papers, which will be presented by to the police. Because enough of this nonsense in Italy here. Nobody can come here and start making use of us in this place here as if he has a dumping ground for anybody. I'm not against anybody. I've seen a lot of people that talk on media here, on Facebook, anything, have never replied anybody one day. If Nigerians will understand, this is a third issue that I've intervened since I came to Italy here on media world. On media. The first one was when a man was beaten up here disgracefully in Ravenna here by some groups of boys. Probably maybe they belong to one group or the other. I don't want to start going into details here anyway. I came out to him and told him, look, we don't even drive anybody in Ravenna to see Ravenna here. And we're not even interested in anybody who whatever he belongs to. But what we don't like is that whatever he belongs to, do not use to intimidate your fellow Nigerians. That was my first intervention. Before one stupid man from Finland, the one that married a 68 years old woman, the woman was older than his mother, was making noise. That the father brought here some years ago here. He managed to cross to Sweden and get a 68-year-old woman to get married to. So, what am I saying? The second one was when, if we just can still recall, when they said the girl that was having AIDS in Bologna here, I intervened in that issue too, before I'm not coming to this issue at this now. Eranomingho has been talking for a very long time. I have never, ever intrude in his campaign, in anything, whatever he's doing. The first day I saw him online, I just wrote to him, look, this is who I am. Probably maybe, I wanted to know much about him. But they never replied. All I had was that I should pay money to register. Oh, me, Muam, Hitro, to pay 100 euro to register for PFM, a man that cannot even express himself. I don't even know if he's left to write. A man that used a girl that has no residence in Italy as a secretary. A man that used a girl that has only been up to 3 years in Italy here as a lodge in his own house. But this is crazy, man. I don't know why Nigerians are keeping quiet with this man. I don't even know whether Nigerian association is not even existing again in Bologna. I think I still have this Igbo man as a Nigerian, you know, president. I still have the man in Bologna. I will check for his name. He's an Igbo man. We met in the embassy some years ago, about 2 or 4 years ago in the embassy when our great king was the ambassador in Rome here. Why should they allow people like that to have a safe haven in Bologna? Well, let it come to Ravenna. Let it come to Ravenna and stay here with any guy in Ravenna here and see whether it will not sleep in jail for 15 years in jail in this place here without even knowing whether he's in jail or not. So people were bold in Ravenna here. One idiot was bold in Ravenna here today. I call him idiot because I've never insulted anybody here since I've been making these issues about Eranomingho. But what you just start seeing this as a baseless because of your personal grudges with somebody. You start writing nonsense on his wall. And people start telling me, I don't let children start insulting you. If children don't insult me, who will insult me? Will it be my mate that will insult me? I will say somebody insulted me. When Buhari was sick in UK, how many Nigerians was praying for him? More than half of Nigerians was insulting him, accusing him of nonsense. People went to his house in the UK, the Nigerian house in UK. Rigi, Buhari, go home. Buhari, go home. If you decide to be a public figure, be expecting insult. It's normal. That does not make you not to be who you are. But most Nigerians know that what I'm saying is the right thing. But we must not continue to live in this bondage. Everybody that knows what I'm saying is true should join up. Share the video. Let this man not have any place to hide in Italy any longer. We welcome anybody that wants to support the Italian government to improve the standard of living of refugees in Italy here. But we don't want anybody to come here and start having hope that he has lost it in a developed society he stayed for 30 years. He has concluded it, wasted all his life over there, and want to start making millions. Just imagine. Let me come here 3-4 months ago. People has already invested $7,000. One person. This is the same accused people are accusing Kanu When I said it, people say, ah, Itro, you know, Biafra is a good idea. Everybody is marginalized in Nigeria. Even the Benins are marginalized. When I say Igbo start complaining, I say, I told them in Ravenna, I said, look, people are complaining. You have five states. It's an Igbo people, Abi. The Edos, Isha, Ora, the Gara people, the Jos, Asaba, the Shakiri, Urobo, Isoko. All these people are all different languages. Two, they are minorities, but they play part as Nigeria. But they were given just two states, 16 languages for two states, and yet we never complain one day. I said, look, Kano, even though you are saying it, carry along those people that are being marginalized more than you, so you have a great support. When I saw Kano back of Kano, I don't see any important person in Nigeria that is supporting Kano. I knew he's going to end quietly. A forgotten story. And what happened? When they burst his house. Tell me one thing. Do you think like somebody like Alese Kweme, those days when he was alive, he's in the house of not Kano, and this is the man who slapped Kweme? He couldn't do that now. At least they have cautious. Somebody is here. But when they came to meet Refresh, all those people that don't even have store in the market, they didn't even know what to say. They destroyed everybody like that. This is the same way I see Eranomingho. When I start seeing those who were standing, sitting by inside, they can't even pronounce one simple English language. In short, those who recruited in Italy, I want better than Eranomingho is speaking English language. Wara. What is that wara? Is that an English language? It is not a state in America that matters a lot. Because most people say, I live in US. Millions live in US. But where did they live in US? In Queens? Or in California or in Texas? Did they matter in the US? You can be in Russia and be a very prominent person in the world. I've already been telling my friends that, look, an intelligent man will always be successful anywhere he is. If you are in Romania, if you are a scientist, if you are in China, you are a good scientist. If you are in Japan, you are a good scientist. If you are in Germany, you are a good scientist. When they come together, nobody translates for them. It's formula. When you say you want to use formula for physics, a Chinese man will just see what you are writing. He knows the solution already. So, what are we not talking about? Eranomingho, we are giving you time to live peacefully. Return that money back. Otherwise, that passport, I'm telling you, the American will seize it from you. You know you don't have you don't even have a land in Nigeria. You don't even have a village you will cry to. I don't even think you have any brother that even greet you in your village. You know that. You were not afraid. You started coming up, insulting Obaseki. Oh my God. This thing is still boiling me to tomorrow. You can insult. People have insulting Buhari. I've never reacted one single day. Even though in Ravenna here, ask anybody, Baba Buhari, I respect that man. He's my mentor. But I've never insulted anybody insulting. You know why? Because they have reasons of doing what they're doing. If you stayed, petroleum minister, they said so. They say it was a former military governor. They lay out some principles. But it was my duty to tell the local, this time around it's a civilian government. What was destroyed in Nigeria for 16 years cannot be re-amended in 2 or 3 years' time. We never quarreled about it. Why must you die for election? Here. If they did not nominate you, try again. But then Adoche's son did. He was he contested. He lost. Today he's in Nigeria. He has never took pain to write anything against anybody in the paper. He has never one day make telephone calls. He has never got to the media, social media, and start insulting anybody. Or Obianu that warned him in what is it? Obianu they call that man in the state. No. Make something constructive. You will go to McDonald's, you will record it. You will go to OVS, where they sell Bobolu wear clothes, 16 euro, 20 euro shoes. You will be showing it in the media. You will go on that trip, you will show it. If you are eating, you don't show it to. When you are in that guest house, you don't show it. When you are doing anything with that, you don't show it. When you are driving those guests to go and go to work and bring money, you don't show it. You think we don't know? I'm just waiting. I'm still waiting. My patience will still go high because I will not allow you to continue using Nigerians the way you are using them, especially the Edo people. I told you before, shine your eye. Shine your eye. This man is a criminal. Those of you who don't know who he's frustrated. Go and check TB Joshua. The confession the ex-wife made in TB Joshua. I watch it regularly here every day.
when they were telling this man is the like the husband, yes sir. He was dumbfounded. This is a man two women has remoted in his lifetime. He has remoted himself in Nigeria by himself now. Family, no good things about. Wife, no good things about. I don't even know whether you have this. Because if you have children at home, you can't even leave them here. I was told the wife born for you in England. And all of these kids live with you in the house. They don't live with you. I don't even think they recognize you as their father. I know Igbo now. Trust America. They are not stupid now. To have a father like you, they will not even want. They can. By now, they have changed their name to their mother's father's surname. I'm very, very sure. So, fellow Nigerians, I am not against this man. I said it before again. I know many of my friends, my foes, have been telling me, no, you are too big for this. Leave this man. This is bullshit. You will receive insult from young ones. No, no reasonable human being will insult me for what I'm saying. Because I've not said what is not provable. I've not said anything that is personal. I'm only this girl I'm talking about. I don't even know her face to face, but I've seen the other sister. His sisters told us all the story that this girl does no longer go to road work. She even shouted. He said that the sister should free those two girls. What the hell? They say Nigerians, some people call us informant. They call us different name. We are not informant. We are trying to at least give good names to our country, Nigeria. People come here to give fallacies. You come here for your hard-earned money. You want to make a good living in Italy here. You have not even got a stay. You have not even got a house. You don't even know any place in this place here. You have already started investing on people to enslave. Oh my God. What did you? Because sometimes I just imagine. Tomorrow you will build four flats in Nigeria. When we go to Nigeria, let's say this one, spent 30 years in Europe, he has not right it back. There's no man that can work a civil servant in Italy yet that can build a 100 million naira house in Nigeria. Even when naira has fallen now, if you convert the money, you cannot convert 100 million by now at 42, at 425 naira per euro. You see how much that money is in dollars or in euros here. If there are so much money in this place here, why are Nigerians carrying mortgages here to buy houses here? They will inflate the price of the house and took 7,000 to 8,000 to Nigeria to go and balance that building house. At the end, they don't pay house for 5 or 6 years, they eject them out of the house. Why are they not buying houses in this place here? If it's really easy to make this money, how can I go and make money? I go and make money as a criminal, then I'll go to Nigeria, I'll be living big. Most of us, they will stay here in the cold, carry blanket to cover. You will have 5,000 in your pocket there. You are saving for 1 or 9 years. You will go and risk yourself or go and buy a big jeep to Nigeria. When you go to Nigeria, Igwe, Rubio, Padomo, and at the end, when you, the honest man that have been working honestly, that has tried to maintain the name of Nigeria, go to Nigeria, not even the immigration will respect you in the airport. This is the situation we have in this place here. So Eranomingho, I am not asking you not to make money in Italy here. You are very free to make money in Italy. Very, very free to make money in Italy here. But you must not use our girls, Nigerians, especially the adults. You will not use them to make money in this place here. From today now, at least I stay at home now. Before I go to Nigeria, I stay at home at least for 2-3 weeks. I will move personally all the camps in Bologna and start searching for this girl. If you don't want to come out and drive this man out of your house, we will come and bring you out. Since you said you don't want to tell us the truth, or you don't want to confess all what this man has been doing to you, you will go to Nigeria. You will go to Nigeria and meet your parents in Nigeria, if that's what you need. They will do it for you. It's very, very simple. Because the police knows the fact. We are not lying to anybody. I live in Ravenna here. If I can stand and tell any policeman that this is what is going on, I don't think they would doubt me. If they would doubt me, at least it would be 3% of what I'm saying. Because, well, I'm not against you, Eranomingho. You're not the only one that is fighting against it. This man in Germany, apart from that, sometimes he uses vulgar words on net. I have never one day called him or insulted him or tell him anything bad like that. I was about to talk about him today, but I got more information about you, of the havoc you are causing to this girl. Leave those guests in the house. Let them go. They are here to hustle for their life. It is not your problem. I don't know whether you have an agreement with the Italian government. Because tomorrow, by God's grace, after I come from the clinic, I will go to the question you have in here first. I give them your name. I ask whether you have any agreement reached for refugees in Italy. Let me see what allow. There's one lady that is showing us video in America. My brother is in America. My uncle is in America. Where all their goods, their load are in the garage. Who knows whether your load too are in the garage in America? Who knows whether you don't have us again in America? Because most of these boys that stays in America, I'm not insulting anybody, my brother. We know that most Africans are living in the streets in the U.S. Time has gone where you use the name of where you live to become who you are. It is what you achieve that people want to know. But achieving it in the right channel. Achieving it in the right channel. So please, I'm begging everybody, if you are here with me, if you are joining me, hey, Haji Fred, God bless you. I'm seeing Jane too and Freddie on Q. I've seen a lot of friends say that online today, but please, just share the video. Let this man know have a resting place in Italy here. Enough is enough. Eranomingho must go. Eranomingho must leave. If he don't leave, he will stay his rest of his life in jail here. Start posting this thing to everybody. Everything that I said here today, wake me up tomorrow morning, I will recall. I don't have any book that I wrote anything here for. Because if you don't know what you are saying, it is when you start reading from paper and start quoting what I wrote for you. These are facts. These are facts. If you think I'm lying, in my wall tomorrow, I will post the statement made by her sister in my wall. Those of you who know my name, who want to join, you can just join it there. It's there. Because yesterday, I gave out the wrong number because I realized that the number I gave yesterday was a little bit more than the number that I supposed to give. Because a little bit I was talking and then at the end I never knew that I gave a SS number. My number is 328-485-0255. Not 555. 328-485-0255. Let every Nigerian just in this crusade. Nobody should come here again and start making Italy as a dumping ground. They come here to talk stories. Bini say, Evo Namali lo, Aganyo. Owa Sogo Wanwe, Owa Agwiwe, Ivi Wanwe Gwan. Owa Ivi Enyiwe Yana. Oma Ede Yamate. For those who don't understand Bini language, a barren, if you don't follow her, you don't know her to her village, where she comes from, when she comes to a new area, she will pretend as if your kids are not well trained. And she will be telling you that, these children, they're not well trained. Are they still asleep? Awake by now. He said to her, why don't you go to bed? She has not even given birth. She has not even been pregnant one day. This is what Eranomingho is doing. A masquerade must dance in his own fest. People will say, look, Jimmy, this masquerade is very, very good. Then he can go and try himself outside. That is where we can invest in on that masquerade. We know that he will bring more money to the village. But Eranomingho, you insult Cartenosa. You insult Obaseki. The commissioner of police, I told you before, I'm not interested about that. That one is a political appointee. Okay. The other day, you had a problem with Kabaka. If this man has got money from any other place he got money from, it was his brain. He was not appointed as a commissioner. He was not appointed anybody. So, blame the government who gave him those rights to be able to make what he makes. Okay. The poor man came to Reggie Miller here. People laid allegations against him. And he was detained for a while. But thank God, he's not my friend. Not my friend. I would not even want to even speak to him. Because what I'm saying is that you cannot be accusing people when you know that those you are accusing, if you are in that position, you will do worse than that. You are just in one small gay house now that I have no document. If eating $7,000. That is the one I know. Because they said I cannot be any work boy. The teeth that eat much of food we eat or chew more of the meat we bite is inside. Not the one we are seeing here. This is Jesus. This one just bite. He test. Carry first of all, voila. Those immolars inside, now they work. So, Eranomingho, we are begging you. We are begging you because I told you yesterday, I said, tell us how much you've received from PFM. Because Blessing confessed that the money she was transferring to your account was the money paid to PFM account. I want to imagine. Just imagine kind of association Nigerians are following in Italy here. Association that created an account with a girl that has no document here in his father, it's the guest father's name. Who is disturbing me? Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Yeah? Sorry, gentlemen. Let me go ahead.
Good evening. My name is Ibrahim Abdul Fasal.
Ibrahim?
Yes.
Go ahead.
I'm from Kano State. So I've been watching your program since all this while. The program, the program is going well, but a friend of mine just make some comment on your work. Decide to like call.
Yeah.
Then you were discussing about $7,000.
Dollars.
Yeah. So the reason I just wanted to know the money, is it for the purpose of setting up the program? The other guy did.
You see,
the money, is it for the program or is it for personal interest or is it for the government? Hold on a minute.
You have credit online, right? You can wait. You can allow me to explain to you, right?
Yes, I have credit.
Okay. The fact is that Eranomingho was having problem with the father of this blessing in Nigeria. Because the blessing was no more picking the phone of the father any longer. She was now a little bit outcast from the family when this master lodging with him in Bologna. Okay, so the elder sister who lives in Bologna before is now in Germany. That one was planning to go to Nigeria. So she bought a car and called the father in Nigeria, look, daddy, this car, I'm going to leave it for you. I'm spending just 2-3 weeks in Nigeria. Okay, so please, clear this car because I have children. I don't want to spend much money. I will stay 2 or 3 weeks, you know. So the father was now dodging the woman from claiming the car. So she was not saying, this is not a character of my father before. At the point she now trying to call to ask the father, tell me what is the problem? Are you in problem? The man had confessed that. Hold on. The man had confessed that.
Okay.
He remitted 1.5 million.
Wow.
1.5 million in euro. Is about $3,000. So remitted it to Eranomingho's account. The guy now said, wow, that was why the man has no money to claim the car in Lagos. Who told you? He said, blessing in Bologna, Italy. Asked the father to remit the money to the place, to the account. Later, the family were now accusing Eranomingho. They now discovered that Eranomingho is trying to do documents. The guy now told the father that Eranomingho wants to do documents for her. Because this poor guy now has no documents. He's just an asylum seeker in Bologna.
Yes, like me too.
Okay, God bless you. So, this guy, they said he's very, very lucky. And we were even told that a white man gave him 40,000 euros. The sister said it. In your phone number, and if I add it to WhatsApp, I will send you the message, the video tape of the sister. So, Eranomingho want to overtake everybody. He now called this man from Germany. What's his name again? I always forget his name. I don't really chat with him. This man, social media president, what's his name?
Okay. I'm not used to people.
Okay. Don't worry. Let me just continue. You know, he called that man and explained that man should go and report this girl father in Nigeria to the police that is forcing her daughter to go to road work. Okay. So the sister now knew that the thing is going too high. Sister now came out on Facebook. I said, look, oh, this is the story that is going on. That as we are talking now, her sister does not go to road work any longer for the past 6 months. That she has 2 guests in their house. That Eranomingho is even the one that is now operating the whole financial issues in Bologna there.
Wow.
This is what is going on. My brother, look, as long as I be here, I am not somebody that comes to the Facebook every time to start talking of things that are not in my business.
Sir,
but, yeah, go ahead.
Like you said, now the story you gave out now is a very bitter, very sad story.
That's the truth.
So you understand?
That's the truth.
For him to just make some decision and defraud, that is fraud, defraud someone.
No, he's not saying that he wants to marry the girl. He said he wants to marry the girl now.
If you want to marry the girl, must you steal from the person before you?
No, the girl too is support. The girl is not telling the parents that money that they remitted to him is not even for her. Okay, if the money was for the PFM, my brother, the money was contributed in Italy here, Abi, or in other parts of Europe. I don't think in Nigeria they can realize such an amount. in Nigeria. Okay, so how did the money go to the account of the father of blessing in Benin if the money was for Eranomingho? This is my point now, because that's what blessing is saying, that money is not for me, oh, it's for Eranomingho. That's why he still owing. She even said she still owing Eranomingho. You know, when girls are in love, when they are in love, if you tell them story,
they do things crazy.
Yes, this is the point. This is what is going on. So I'm annoyed because I cannot live here for decades and allow one stupid man that cannot even express himself in English language after 30 years in the US to come here to technically as a safe haven. He went to Belgium, he couldn't spend 1 week.
Sir, like the way you said now, the best option for me to say to you now, you could just give an advice for the upcoming girls and the young men coming up. They should stop defrauding from the black people and the people you claim you've been in love with, or you just try to advise we.
It's like you came here lately, right? I told everybody before that not even Berlusconi, our ex prime minister, give you a stay in Italy here.
It's true.
The only man that can assign stay to you in Italy here is the president.
Okay.
Is the president that can give you pardon. He's the same man that can release a prisoner from death sentence or from life sentence and say, look, I pardon you, just like Buhari can do in Nigeria.
Yes.
He's a ceremonial man. He's the one that signed your passport if you become an Italian citizen. Those are his duties. He can't... Any law passed in Italy here that is not signed by him is null and void. So, how much more, Eranomingho, you tell them that the ID card can enable them to seek for asylum? What is asylum? Is somebody who is in problem in this country, Abi?
Yes.
But sometimes, I do translating in the court for Nigerians here too sometimes. Sometimes, when they see your story is not so pure, they are not so convinced. But when they look at your nature, and they look at the way you present the story, they look at the way you are humble, they can give you humanitarian.
Yes.
Humanitarian means, let's just give him for human purpose. As a human being, let's just give it to him. When they believe your story, they give you 5 years, which is quality. You understand? So this man is trying to work on them. When he came, he just choose those rich flash in Italy here and start working on them. And most of our leaders in Italy here kept quiet, allowed this man to siphon our girls, siphon our men, those who came newly, and make money from them. A lot of money from them, my brother. A lot of money. Because to move from one country to another, even though it's Ryan Airline, 150 euros, go and come. If you do it for 6 months, you will bankrupt, no matter how much you receive in a month.
Yes. You are saying the truth. You are just saying everything. That is the fact. But we just hope others will learn from this.
I won't call it a mistake.
I'm talking to you. I'm still under the Italian government. I'm still under the asylum.
My brother, my advice to you, follow the rules and regulations.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Do it to the maximum. It might be long because any road to success are not very easy. Some of us will come here after 6 months, they will run away from camp. They want to go and hustle to carry land in to go and take land in the K1 road. They want to build Marshall. They are looking at that
door. No
problem. No problem.
You
are welcome. God bless you too. God bless you. So let's go back to our discussion again. Because I'll be leaving very soon because I just have 1 hour to spend here. I started by 9 o'clock. I'm going to leave by 10. So we still waiting for Eranomingho to prove himself that we are wrong. He must prove us wrong. If Eranomingho cannot prove us wrong, then we'll tell him that we are not kids in Italy here. You don't just start doing things the way you want just because people don't understand what is going on. The US Eranomingho himself, I can even tell him some of his rights that we don't even know. I begin to imagine whether Eranomingho go to interview before he become an officer as a warder. I think nobody should be proud to be a warder. When you say you are a warder in Nigeria, it's somebody like working in the train line in Nigeria. Then you are a train worker in Nigeria. You start seeing comrade officer, Eranomingho, Edegbe. Wow. I thought he was from Ronigbe. But thank God he's not from Ronigbe. Because if he was from Ronigbe, it would be worse for him. Because people who are here in Italy here that could be able to say, look, stop disgracing our town or whatever we come from. So, fellow Nigerians, I may not be so perfect in everything I'm saying here today, but the grievances in me is much, 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 much more. Because every day we start hearing new developments. What I just told you this evening today, most of Nigerians don't know about what was going on. Nobody knew about this blessing before. Nobody knew about 7,000 euros, because the sister says it's 3.5, total amount in Naira. In Naira, 3.5. They've invested so far on it that he don't call anybody in Nigeria again now. He's just concentrated on this man in order to get married. That they're able to send somebody from America to this place here. Tell our government must hear all these things, because nobody should start playing pranks on us in Italy here. We are men of timber and caliber. If you want to get a stay in Italy here, you pass through the normal process. If you are in problem in your city or in your country, it doesn't mean you must be having war in Nigeria to become an asylum seeker in Italy here. You can be having a very serious problem. There are people or ladies who their parents still want them to force them for circumcision, especially the robos. If you escape that and come to Italy here and make your proof right, because they are against circumcisions of girls in the world, there was an evidence. It depends how you present it. It is not by painting your story. It's not by painting your story big so that you want them to believe you. At the end, you can't defend yourself. When you start lying, they start seeing you. My father told me once before, say, look, he said, every other body can lie, but this eye does not lie. You can say, oh, I was here 2 o'clock. But when I'm looking at your eyes, if I see the way you blink your eye, I know this man is lying already. So, our topic will end throughout this week. We'll go throughout this week talking about this issue. I don't want to go start blogging with people or start carrying my listen to YouTube. I said, no. Good product. Will advertise himself. Anybody that knows what I'm saying here today is worth sharing, share it. Anybody that knows that you don't want to start to fall a victim of this kind of thing again, share it. Anybody that knows that what I'm saying here today is right, just share it. So that they will get the lesson. My number is there. Somebody just called just now, right? Because I blocked you before. All of a sudden, I don't know how you'll be able to ring through, right? If you have any doubt, you are still in the camp, or you are declaring Aduro political refugees in Italy here, let nobody deceive you. If you are not saying the truth, or you cannot stand by what you say, you go nowhere. And if you go nowhere and you comport yourself very well, God might see you through. Because man purpose, God dispose. So, my fellow brothers and sisters, I'll be leaving early a little bit because time is fast spent. Today I want to go to do other things that are very, very important. Because I'm filing his case file. I have to put things down that I have to present to the questura, to any authority that will help us to drive him out of Italy here. If because he has the American passport, he can't go to jail in Italy here, at least he will be prosecuted in America. Because I know that America will always defend their citizens anywhere they are. But we should know that this place is no longer a safe haven for him. It will no longer be a safe haven for him in this place anymore again. So that man, I call him that boy, that was brought in to Italy by his uncle, which I know very well, which I will not mention your name here, your full name. You know I know you very well. When you use that statement today, that get to the laugh pot, I laugh over you. You know why? Because somebody that is mad is better than you in Italy here today, in Ravenna here today. We all know. Because a man that is above 35 years of age, that decided to bring kids to earth, that cannot bring them up in a decent manner, take care of them financially, give them food, give them affection, that man is not fit to live on earth. Neither is he fit to talk to other fellow men. If I were you, I would lock myself inside the room and commit suicide. God forbid that anyway. Because the Bible says we shouldn't take our lives. If not, I would advise you to do that because your life is worse than that. Your wife take care of you. Your wife give you food. Your wife take care of your children. You don't even have respect. You don't even know how to do your duty as a man. And yet you come to net and talk to me. Yeah. According to Igbo people. You are not afraid. Because if you are afraid, you know why? They said a prophet is not respected in his hometown. You're supposed to know that you don't see me on on media, talking rubbish on media without nobody has done anything. Has done anything that will provoke me. Okay, you just can't stay and let me know what I'm doing. That I just keep quiet because you are living in Ravine at this place here. If you want me to drive you Ravine, I will drive you too. That one is very simple because you are not worth staying in this place here. You are a nuisance to everybody. You drink from one bar to another. You don't create one single money. Or you don't work. You don't do anything. So what kind of life is that? So please, ladies and gentlemen, I will wait for tomorrow for another day. I want to beg everybody. I cannot stay too longer because I have to take care of other issues now. Thank you very much and God bless. May God bless everybody who stayed up to now. But don't miss it. Tomorrow we'll come earlier. Probably maybe we'll be there by 8 o'clock. Thank you all.